What's up, bitches?
Hello, YouTube and all who inhabit it. Greetings from the Stop Motion Viewer. Today we're going to be taking a look at the War for Cybertron Earthrise Deluxe Class Wheeljack. Wheeljack transforms into a 1980s Lancia Stratos, which is my friggin' babe car apparently, because good god, look at this vehicle mode. The 1980s hot rod energy this gives off is incredible. The Tampa Graph detail with all the sponsors is a touch that was added that they didn't need to add, because Combiner Wars did so well without them. Every detail on this car mode is painted to absolute perfection. The low-riding, sleek, aerodynamic look is the absolute shit on this car. I would talk more about the car mode, but there really isn't much else to talk about. The green, red, and white paint on this thing is executed absolutely fantastic. But let's get on to transformation. The transformation on this vehicle mode is actually really fun and addicting. The back of the car becomes the arms, the front of the car becomes the feet, and the rest of him just folds out almost flawlessly. The transformation can get finicky because of certain transparent parts on the vehicle mode not being attached to a pin or anything, but that's about the only problem with transformation, and we'll get to that in a bit. In his robot mode, Wheeljack rocks the absolute most perfect head sculpt we have ever gotten from a generation's Wheeljack. No half-done, half-done bullshit silhouette like Combiner Wars, no gorilla-like proportions from Generations, just a good G1 square-looking Wheeljack. So here's the question. Why does Hasbro insist on making him look like complete shit in all the stock images they took of him? Who the hell runs the marketing for these figures? It's like the design team all just came together and says, I cannot emphasize this enough. We must show all the hollow parts on the figure. We have to make the consumer cringe at the cheap white-looking plastic. Also, the arms have to be half-transformed. We want them to look like the end pieces of fucking sandwich bread. Can we at least show off the ankle tilt? No, we have to make him look like trash. We cannot let consumers know we want to sell this figure. But anyways, Wheeljack does the usual siege thing that can make him from Wheeljack to Wheeljacked. Weaponize this bitch up more than Galaxy Upgrade Prime will probably be my next review. All weapons aside, the base mode figure comes with this tiny pea shooter gun, and it almost looks like it's mind-controlled lunchbox to get Grimlock into control. Posability on the figure is pretty great. You can tilt the head slightly to the side because of the ball joints, giving him the inquisitive inventor look. Or you can have him show off the robot dinosaur with the intelligence of a toddler and the unhinged aggression of an actual dinosaur, making Ratchet facepalm. Posability aside, there are some quality control problems on this figure. The black clear plastic that flips onto the inside of the legs pops off really easily, and it's really fragile. The chest piece also has a tendency to pop out of its hinge when you don't rotate the waist in a certain way. The inside of the legs are hollow, and this is starting to kind of annoy me on deluxes at this point, because Wheeljack is about as tall as Hound, meaning that he is one of the shortest deluxes that we've gotten besides Cliffjumper. But he's a fantastic-looking Wheeljack, which we haven't gotten a lot of, and we've only gotten about, well, this is the only Generation 1 accurate Wheeljack we've ever gotten that looks this good. So that's why I'm going to go ahead and be generous and give Wheeljack a 9 out of 10. It's a great figure with one or two quality control issues that can't really go ignored, and for that reason I had to take off some points somewhere. This has been the Stop Motion Reviewer, and I'll see you all in my next review, probably on Galaxy Upgrade Optimus Prime.